Hi, welcome to another episode of Chandigarh Data Recovery Labs based in North India. This is your host Amarbir, and this is a case today which we have received from a rural area from my state Punjab. The guy has a ST500 LM012 Seagate hard drive, which is actually a Samsung hard drive actually. And it's a double head drive. I have not seen quite a lot of these drives, by the way. I have seen the 1 terabytes quite common inside the lab. And so this was a little different. I was actually anticipating that this is going to be a double platter and four heads, but it is unfortunately one platter and two heads. But the weight is virtually the same, like the ST1000LM024. So let's get going with this case and see if we can recover this data today for this young man. So here is the drive working in action. I have hooked it up to my professional data recovery setup, and I am currently reading the negative cylinders of this hard drive so that I can grab all the service area information. Service area includes the read-only memory, the complete content of the ROM. It includes all the modules based in the negative cylinders, and it also includes all the tracks which are populated. You can see that the grabbing of the data is going on right now. So this is very, very critical for the work, because if we are not able to grab the surface area, then might be if we land up into the problem later on, we are not able to actually work with the drive again. So it is critical to do this step before we do everything else. But of course, before I did that, I have inspected the PCB for short circuits and also done all the general cleaning before. So the next step in this recovery would be that we take another 500 GB hard drive and put it onto the destination port of the tool, so that we can clone all the good readable sectors from the defective hard drive into that donor destination drive. And once that is done, we can grab the data from the donor and transfer it to the third drive. So I am still working with the negative cylinders, the SA area of this hard drive yet. So once that step is done, I am going to show you what is the next step in this recovery. The setup now here is very, very powerful. I have added some more tools into this system, which I'm not going to disclose much, but it's made this current main setup very, very powerful for a data recovery work. So this is the drive which is now hooked up for receiving the data into it. This is the cloned this is going to be the cloned destination drive. Okay, so now the task for this customer is created in the tool, and we are able to read the ID of the patient drive, and we also have the destination receiving drive hooked up to the tool. Both of them are working. So what's the next step now? The next step is that, as we know, that every hard drive has a couple of heads. They are different heads. So we are first going to create a map. Map basically means which sector is addressed by which head. We are going to create a head map. Once the head map is created, we'll come to know what are the, how many number of heads are there inside this drive. And if we have to tackle a particular weak spot in a particular area of a particular head, we'll be able to do that. So let's focus on that, and I'll show it to you in the tool. So here we go to the tool and we say we want to build the head map. Then we come to this screen. Here it is asking us for what area. We are going to select the entire area. It's going to ask us for which surface area to use. We are going to select all, and I'll take it a little back, and here it is creating the head map, and you can see that the head map is rolling down now slowly this side, and ultimately you will see the head map over here. You can see now that the two heads which are there inside the map is now created. So now what's the next step? So the next step of recovery would be that we are now going to tell the tool to show us the number of partitions that are there inside this drive. If we are able to find all the partitions, we can then work further. I will explain it to you step by step again. So you can see that we are able to see all the drives, all the partitions in this drive. But this guy has actually, I don't know why people do this, but they screw up the case a little bit, you know, for us guys to recover. I mean, here he has just formatted his C drive. You can see there is nothing absolutely here. And his D drive actually is not able to show anything inside. Then he has another, you know, partition which he's able to, we are able to view the files. Then he has one another partition in which again we are able to see the files. So it's not a very simple case in my opinion. I have no idea why the guys do it like this, but everybody who watches my video and you have such kind of an issue in your drive, stop using the drive, send it to us. We will look into it and we'll try to recover most of your data. So this guy has really complicated the work for us. Now I have to focus on the drive, which is actually not showing to me, because I'm pretty sure that has some you know, bad sectors into it. And I will first clone all the working drives I can see, then I'll focus on the problematic drive. Right, so I have now tagged some of the folders which I think are important, and I'm going to create a list of those files and folders which are here. And you can see it swiftly went away, and now we have a list of all the files and folders which the guy actually needs. So this is the last partition which I am able to see with my tool. So I'm going to copy whatever it takes, you know, to do this. So I'll use some of my preferences and start cloning this hard drive. We can see that the tool is now working with the drive. Head 0 is getting cloned right now, and the status says it's 2.5 GB of data right now into this. So hopefully it should be done. All right, so you saw that one of the partitions I was now cloning, and that is done. I have now started cloning one partition before the last partition. The thing is that I would like to do recovery from the inside zone to the outside zone, then from the outside zone to the inside zone, because the damage is mostly on the outer zone. So it is not good to drag your heads on that zone. It's better to do it from inside to outside. This second last partition is pretty much big. It's around 17.9 GB, and you can see that the text is moving around here. So slowly we are cloning this data for the second last partition. So the second last partition is also finished, and I am now planning to work on the third last partition. And in this partition I don't see any structure of data, so I will clone this entire partition, which is around 100 GBs. And once I clone it, later on I'll see what I have to do with it, how we have to recover the data logically from it, so that meaningful data for the customer is extracted. You can see that we don't find any files on the top. We only find that it is cloning the entire 100 GB of data, and here approximately 16% is done. So you can see 16-17% is done. Hopefully in a little while we'll be able to clone this entire partition. So once this third last partition is cloned, in which we don't find any folder structure, we'll concentrate on drive C, which is the first partition of the drive. And I think that the customer has formatted that. Lot and lot of people have this misconception that if they have to give a hard drive to a data recovery guy, they can actually, you know, format the drive, and come what may, we'll recover the data. So don't do that. it is not good. It complicates our task a little bit more. So that drive also, because I am not able to see any structure, I am again going to clone that entire partition in reverse order, because I don't want to stress the heads back again, because in the second pass I have to work on all the areas which are there, which are left in the C drive and also in the D drive. So it's getting interesting. This is a very different kind of video that I'm making. I'm shooting it in small clips, then I'll put all these clips together, and I am very sure that you like this video, because this is a recovery of a proper live case from starting till end, one by one, step by step. So all right, now I am in the process of cloning the C drive, and I'll show you the screen here, which you can see. It's around 48.7 GB, and we are done by, it's around 12 GB is finished. So this is the C drive. Once the C drive is also done, I'm going to go to pass 2, and in pass 2 I'm going to focus on all the sections and the sectors which were not read, and try to read them so that I can grab maximum amount of data from this failing hard drive. So here we are now focusing on all the areas which were left by the tool in the first pass, and we are currently now working on these so-called yellow spots and turning them into green, or mostly turning them into black, like you can see over here. So once this second stage of recovery is gone, then we'll proceed to the next step, which is actually finding the data which is lost in the C and the D drive. So now we pretty much have everything cloned from the drive, from the patient failing drive. And now we are going to work on that C and D drive and try to get the data in a proper, proper format, which is viewable instead of raw. And then, work on it logically now, and then see the data. And if we are actually able to, get the data, it's going to be a great job. Okay, so guys, we have managed to recover the data from his C and D drive also. Data is all around here, and I called up this guy. The guy is very, very happy to find out that we have recovered his data. So if you actually have a case of these Seagate Samsung drives, the Samsung hard drive department was purchased by Seagate a few years back, and now we have basically all these Samsung drives with Seagate written on the top. So ST1000LM024 and this ST500LM012. So if you have such kind of drives, you're most welcome to contact us and give us an opportunity to recover your data. We do a very good task on most of the drives which we receive. Mechanical hard drives is my specialty, and so is NAND flash. If you have working or dead SD cards, working or dead CF cards, and working or dead micro SDs, do give us a try. And our phone number is 9815000133. This is your host Amarbir from Chandigarh Data Recovery, and stay tuned for the next kick-ass YouTube video on data recovery from our side, and see you guys.